everybody. Welcome back to my channel, Comfort and Joy with Lady Curry. So I just got in from making a Walmart run, and this run was not a serious run. It was pretty much a junk food run, a few necessities, but yeah, that noise you hear is my electric kettle. The little lady and I are going to have some noodles. So I just got back from Walmart and I picked up some noodles. Let me turn you guys around. Okay, that's better. So what happens is every time you find something that you like, it seems like it always goes out of stock. So when I went back in, I saw that they had them in stock and I saw that they had a sufficient amount. So I went ahead, and I know this isn't healthy food and it's not good for you, but this is only like once in a while, not even once a week, honestly, with me and the little lady. But I had bought a few of these a while ago and we both liked them. So after that, we were out of them for like at least a month or more. And so I said, well, when I see them again, I'll make sure that I stock up on them, whatever, put them back in my stash. And then also these bowls here, she likes these sometimes to take for lunch and or to have like a snack or even dinner when she doesn't want something too heavy, because we do, you know, when I cook for her, she eats chicken, beef, pork, you know, seafood, salmon, and she has heavy meals for dinner and for lunch sometimes. So sometimes she just wants like either cereal or like something like noodles. So then I went ahead and just picked up some few items. Like I'm going to a Mother's Day jazz brunch tomorrow, and I had some items I had to get. So these Catalinas go in my sweet and sour meatballs. I picked up a cucumber for my noodles because I love cucumbers and noodles. I picked up some hair color because your girl's grays are popping and I'm not embracing them yet because, you know, I'm not all the way there yet. I had to pick up some raisins. I normally get my raisins from Costco, but it's rainy out, cold. I didn't feel like fighting through the crowd. So I'm going to just go ahead and contend with that. That'll get me through my next baking batch. I just made some sheet cakes for the little ladies' teachers for Teacher Appreciation Week and also for our teachers at the center at our church daycare. And then I just also, these were on sale, like these were like 52 cents. I was like, I had to get them. Sometimes I crave them. The little lady doesn't like them. Well, so far she doesn't. But I crave these macaroni and cheese, Kraft macaroni and cheese boxes. Sometimes I will pair them with either broccoli or peas, like frozen peas. I'll throw them right in the water while I am boiling the macaroni, and then I'll put some albacore tuna in them. So delicious. So I'll make like a quick meal, something junk foody that, you know, I don't necessarily want to have like a healthy meal, whatever, you know, something quick. And then some Takis. The little lady requested her Takis. And then I picked up a case of ginger ale. And then I also, over here, picked up two big bags of her Fruit Loop. She's been loving these to snack on. I also picked up two Mott's applesauce containers for her to, you know, have for dinner and or lunch or just a snack. But normally it's just dinner or lunch. And then I also picked up two of the orange marmalade jellies. I normally do Smuckers, but I was feeling cheap today. And then I also picked up some Minute Maid lemonade. And then I've also picked up some items for the little lady's personal needs. So she already took those up to her room. But that was it. And I'm going to just go ahead and try to get these things put away. And I have on my agenda today. Okay. I thought I would turn you back around. So I have on my agenda today to wash the little lady's hair and my hair. We're going to see, because I do want to color my hair and curl it for tomorrow's brunch. And I want to pick out what, you know, I'm going to wear. It's so cold outside. Like, I could have had my winter coat on, but I just had this shawl on, my hat, and this, duster sweater. That's one of my favorites. I bought it from either Macy's or Nordstrom's years ago. Was the little lady born? I don't even know if she was born. She was just born. It may have been before her. I'm not sure. That's how long I've had this sweater, but it's been a long time. But yeah, so I'm just going to get stuff done. I don't have anything really going on that's special or exciting, except for tomorrow we'll be doing our Mother's Day jazz brunch, which is going to be very nice. I'm going to try to pull my camera out. I know I failed you guys with the tea. I was supposed to film the tea. I think I filmed a little bit. I'm not sure. Or no. One of my other ladies filmed it, and I had asked her to give me her footage so I can include it. But that was in April. We're already in May, about to go into June. But yeah, so sometimes I'm just living in the moment. And I don't always either get a chance to pull out my phone and film, or I'm not thinking about it because I'm really just trying to take it in at that very moment. So tomorrow, hopefully I will remember to pull my camera out. Like, my family's coming up. So I'll have my own mommy, 89 years young. She's coming up to celebrate. We're going to celebrate her. My eldest sister, she's coming up as well as my sister that's right above me, my hitter. She's my day one, Miss Tanya. So she's coming up as well. My other sister, Fran, she is doing a lot of like business transactions and real estate things. So she could not be available tomorrow. So we're missing her. My bonus sister, Juanita, she's coming up too. She's driving everybody up. So that's going to be exciting. So I'm going to really try to get some footage, because I do like to like earmark and take a videography of, you know, special events, so we can kind of look back on these and have them. I don't know how long YouTube would be around or whatever, but for as long as it will be around, I think that it'll be nice for me to chronicle different events that's going on in our lives. So yeah, so that's pretty much what's going on. It's just a uneventful, rainy Friday, and it's the Friday before Mother's Day. And let me just take the time to say, just in case I don't get a chance to say it tomorrow, because I probably won't, happy Mother's Day. I may pop in on Sunday, and then as this video is uploaded, I don't want to have it next week, but I probably will have to upload it for next week. But let me just say happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there, whether you are biological, adopted, spiritual, in any other way that you were brought in to the office in a position of mother. I want to say happy Mother's Day, and we honor you today. The office is such a gift from God. It really is. It's a sacrificial office, and for those of us who get it and know, we definitely know that, but we do it out of love, and we really wouldn't have it any other way. A true mother that has the heart of a mother, which comes from God, honestly, would not have it any other way. We love the ups and the downs. We you know, we love to grow from them. And that's one thing that I did say about me personally as a mom. I bombarded the heavens for my child. We had to wait 11 years to have her, like 11 years into our marriage. It took us 11 years of marriage to get her. And we've had her, God thank you, for 13 precious years. We really could not have asked for a better child, a better daughter. She's such a gift from God. She was a miracle in every sense of the word. And we're just blessed. Her demeanor, her countenance, she brings joy to our family. She makes us chuckle. She makes us learn. She stretches us, and we should not often ask her, like I say, am I doing a good job as a mom? Do you need anything from me? Is it something that I'm like missing? Because I really want to. I prayed to God. I really did. And I was like, Lord, you continue to grow me and to lead me into the position of mother for her, because that's your child. And I need to be the mother that you need me to be for her, so she can develop and I can guide her, so she can hit all her marks. I want her to hit as many marks as she can that God intended for her to hit as she's growing up. And if we're not aware and conscious of, we're raising our children to release them out into the world, and who will they be once we release them out into the world? And I want her to be a mighty woman of God. I want her to bless people. I want her to love God so much that she walks past somebody and they feel the love of God. I want her to be so anointed that she goes anywhere and that healing maybe takes place, you know, deliverance takes place, all of that. Like, that's something that I long for too, as I continue to grow into, you know, grow in our faith and our walk, that we are truly used by God, especially in these end times. Like, we need to really seek the Lord and make sure that we're being used by God in any way, whether it be from our words, whether it be through our prayers, that we're praying effectively for people, we're standing in the gap for people, we're meeting the needs of people, we're not, we're healing and not harming, we're healing and not hindering, things of that nature. So that's all. I'm very sensitive in terms of that as a mom. Like, it may be too much and all that, but you know what? That's y'all problem. Whoever feels that way, that's your personal problem. But I just want to be the best mom I can be. I fall short sometimes. I can be a little aloof, maybe. I like to say that. Sometimes I don't always catch certain things until maybe after. But that's always a learning mark as well. So that's all I'm just trying to say. I want to be the best mom that I can be. I'm growing and I'm learning on this journey, as I have a 13-year-old, most of my girlfriends, if not all of them, already have grandchildren. I'm the last one out the group that is a young mom. Like, I have a young child under 16. So I'm going through these phases for the very first time. And, you know, with the wisdom of God and also raising nieces and nephews and all that type of stuff, I have a little bit of motherhood under my belt. And then I have all these babies under me and things of that nature. And then God just gives you wisdom and mother wit. That comes from God as well. And then having wonderful mothers like my mother and my grandmother, and then my sisters, like my eldest sister, Ellie, she helped raise me in terms of, she always had me. I was on her hip from a child, so much so that I thought that she was my mother at first, because she would take me everywhere. And so just having siblings that are almost old enough, well, she was old enough to have me if she had me like at 14, 15. That was young, but you know what I mean. She was able to have me if that were the case, and she raised me. But yeah, so that's all I'm just trying to say, that I have a lot of phenomenal women, even to my late sister-in-law, Deborah Williams. She was a very powerful presence in my life, a powerful, persuasive person that I could look up to, that gave me wisdom. She always pointed me to Christ, just like my mom points me to Christ. My sisters, they point me to Christ. Like, they try not to tear down. They talk me towards doing the right thing. And what does the word of God say? So if you don't have women in your life like that, you need to get some. Get some women in your life that will point you to Christ, that will point you to do the godly thing and not even side with you when, say, my feelings are hurt or whatever, and I may be wrong in something. Well, you shouldn't have said that. No, but, oh, Rosa, you said that or whatever, and, or no, but maybe you could pick up a little and do this or do that, or think of it this way. Look at it from this perspective. They will, they don't side with me because they love me and I'm just, you know, their baby girl, baby sister or daughter. Mm-mm. They normally will point me to Christ, point me to the word of God, and point me to do what's right. Now, if I am right or whatever, they'll, you know, say, okay, well, let's do this or let's look at it this way. But I get good counsel. I really do. Good, wise counsel. I don't, you know, pull my family into everything, but I'm just saying in terms of like girlfriends or mentors, I get good wise counsel. If someone is not pointing you to Christ and giving you good sound advice, especially based off of the word, if we are calling ourselves Christians, you need to run, okay? But anyway, I said all of that to say, happy Mother's Day, mothers out there. I love you guys. We are doing it. Even when we don't feel like we're doing it, we are enough. We are doing enough, probably too much. And it's okay to be tired. It's okay to want to take that extra nap. It's okay to have some me time because you do pour out. So you need to pour back in. So we, self-care is essential, okay? I didn't always believe that, but yes, it is. So, all right. So let me get this stuff cleaned up and get my kitchen a little bit in order, because this kitchen is a mess right now, and it's also due partly because I was baking all yesterday for my teachers and things, so for Teacher Appreciation Week. So yeah, but I love it. I love the chaos. It just means that we're living, right? All right, y'all. I'll talk to y'all later. Meatballs in this tin here. And this is a recipe, a sweet and sour recipe that I got from the, I think it was the Pioneer Woman. And she, had shared this recipe years ago. Oh boy, it's hard to get off. Yeah, she shared it years ago and I loved it ever since. And every time I make it for any type of gathering, everybody always loves it. So I always make it. And so I'm going to go ahead and just make it. I think it's only going to take one. Yep. Get a little bit of shake to shake out the excess. Check out the excess. There we go. Okay. Now, Okay. And we're gonna put this in here. Okay. I also add red pepper flakes to give it some kick. Give it a kick. So you can add as little or as much as you like. I normally like to add a nice amount, maybe like a half a tablespoon or something like that. And I already washed my hands twice, okay? And then, okay, and then we're gonna add our Liam Perrins Worcestershire sauce, that. And I just give it a few shakes to give it that nice little kick, about 2 teaspoons. So I don't measure this anymore, but and then just mix it up. And what you'll do is, as it heats through, it's going to get really glazy and really yummy, and it's going to get toasty and caramelized. And I believe that's it. I think that's all I do. And I think that's all the recipe called for. Yep. Just try to mix it in. See if you can get all your meatballs tossed and coated before you put them in the oven. And I'm just going to, and normally I make this in a crock pot because it'll hang out all day in a crock pot so it can get nice and glazy. But, when I'm making a really large batch like this, I normally cook in these pans here. And so I just keep tossing until all of them look like they're coated well. And yeah. Yep. And then you're just gonna keep turning them like as they cook for, I let them go for hours, honestly. Like, well, yeah, I guess you could say that, hours in the crock pot. So while they're in a crock pot, they do go for hours. And in the oven, I probably let them go for a couple of hours or so. Because the heat on the oven is a little different. And I just have it set to 375. And so I just want to make sure that all of my meatballs are coated nicely on all sides before I pop it in. And I can cover it. I like to cover it. So I'm gonna get the, there we go. Mm-hmm. There we go. Mm-hmm. I'll just try to put them in a nice little thin layer if you can. Sometimes I have 2 bags of these and it's like a lot of meatballs, depending on how big the crowd is. And I may even have to make the other bag. I'll see what the hubby says. I'll see what he says if it's not enough and he wants some more. We do have another bag. So, okay. All right, let me put on my lid. Put my lid on. And I'll pop it in the oven. Only thing about these pans. Okay. Only thing about the big pans is sometimes they don't work well with the oven. So yes. Okay. Okay, so the deacons gave us roses at the door.
You really have to come here dressed up.
Yeah. And then here is the red carpet. Oh, this is pretty. Okay, I'm ready. Good morning. Good morning, everyone. Oh, it's so beautiful in here.
Good morning.
Oh, look at the tables. It's so pretty. Hey, Trudy. Hey, lady. Good morning. Happy Mother's Day to everyone. Good morning. I guess I don't know where daddy's at. This is so iffy. I'm sorry. I'll sit out and I don't know where daddy's at. This is so iffy.
your mouth full. Mama taught us, eat everything that is on your plate because there are children starving. China, Africa, different regions, anywhere that was far for us, anywhere that was far. Mama taught us to clean up what you mess up. Mama taught us to look both ways before you cross the street. Make sure that you always have a clean pair of underwear because you never know when you're going to have an accident. Mama taught us, also taught us lessons like, you playing dumb doesn't make anyone smarter. She taught us, mean children make mean adults, and they're both insecure.
All right.
She taught us to pursue our dreams, not just the ones that seem possible. She said, always keep enough money to get yourself home. She said, never downplay your own brilliance.
That's right.
Mama taught us that it's important for us to have our own stuff. Because mama may have, and papa may have, but God bless the child who has their own.
I hope you enjoyed the little snippets that I did include. I tried to include some of the festivities that went on. And the little lady and I, who does not want to be on camera, were just coming from Costco. So I had to get gas and then I had to run into Costco to get a few things. So now I'm gonna go home and decompress. We're gonna wash our hair and get ready for Mother's Day tomorrow. The little lady also has to dance tomorrow, so we also ran up to the dance shop to get her her uniform, her bottoms that she needed, because the previous pair she owned was too small for her. So we had to, and I learned of it last minute because something told me, did you throw them out or does she even still have those pants? And when I asked her, she said, no, I don't have them anymore. So we had to make a quick run. But all tasks have been completed. It's been a wonderful day. And we're about to go home and just wind down a little bit, but we still have a lot of tasks to complete for tonight. So yeah. All right, guys, I will pop in later.
Oh,
So thank you everybody for watching, especially if you stayed around to the very end. I appreciate you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching and clicking on the video. I hope and pray that you guys had a wonderful Mother's Day. Those who lost your moms, I'm praying for you that you be strengthened and that those memories will be a blessing to you and your soul, and that you would gain strength and joy and comfort from those precious memories. But yes, so thank you so much. The weekend has been well spent, and thank you guys. So let me just also take the time to say, please remember to like, comment below, hit the notification bell, also share if you would be so kind to do so. And also, if you are not a Comfort and Joy family member, please consider subscribing to the channel. It will help my channel out a lot. And I would love to have you as a part of the Comfort and Joy family. As always, this is Lady Curry wishing you comfort and joy from my heart to yours. Until the next video, guys, I will see you in the next one. Be blessed. Take care.